This is Shibaji Sarkar. We are going to talk about our recent article, The Epigenetic Drugs in Disease. Epigenetics is a new topic which involves reversible modifications of histones, which includes acetylation and methylation, and also modification of DNA sequences by methylation. These reactions are reversible and has a huge impact on the development. And now we observe that the epigenetic changes can regulate disease formation. So in this review, we addressed four types of diseases, mainly cardiovascular, neurological, metabolic, and cancer. And in the coming time, my co-authors will discuss each of the items we cover in this review.
The association of epigenetic changes in cardiovascular disease is not well studied. However, epigenetic changes are known to be associated with the expression of ortholoprotective estrogen receptors, the vasodilator nitrous oxide, and certain coronary artery diseases. In this review, we discuss some of these aspects. Histone deacetylase inhibitors have been shown to improve recovery after myocardial infarction and could be useful in stem cell therapy for heart muscle regeneration.
Epigenetics is known to play a key role in the development of the nervous system. Dysregulation of these epigenetic mechanisms is associated with neurological diseases such as Rett's disease, Huntington's disease, and Parkinson's disease. Histone deacetylase inhibitors have been shown to have neuroprotective effects and are thought to prevent permanent brain damage following stroke. Histone deacetylase inhibitors are also associated with increased synaptic plasticity and memory formation, suggesting a possible treatment for neurodegenerative diseases.
Epigenetics is also known to be associated with several metabolic disorders, including diabetes and obesity. Transient hyperglycemia can lead to long-lasting epigenetic changes that are associated with diabetic complications. In addition, the epigenetic status of several genes at birth is linked to levels of adiposity later in life. Accordingly, due to the reversible nature of epigenetic modifications, it's thought that the use of epigenetic drugs may be able to help prevent diabetes and obesity, though more research is needed in this regard.
The role of epigenetics in cancer is perhaps the most well-studied of all epigenetic-related diseases. It is known that many tumor suppressor genes become epigenetically silenced during cancer, and our lab has postulated that epigenetics regulates cancer progenitor cell formation, cancer progression, and metastasis. Two epigenetic drugs are currently FDA-approved for the treatment of cancer, a methylation inhibitor, Vidaza, and a histone deacetylase inhibitor, vorinostat. While these drugs are effective against leukemias, solid tumors are not as responsive to these treatments. Combining epigenetic drugs with other types of anti-cancer drugs, however, is showing promise in many research studies and clinical trials.
In conclusion, we like to say that epigenetics has a huge impact on almost every aspect of biology and disease. Like, if you think about cancer, we think that the cancer initiation and even the drug-resistant cancer is dependent on epigenetic changes. So we try to address this issue in this review, and it will be further investigated whether there is an epigenetic code which can be addressed to solve these type of problems. Thank you.